Immigration Minister Jason Kenney says the Roma people appear to be high on the list of those making what he calls bogus refugee claims and were part of the motivation behind what he has called the Protecting Canada's Immigration System Act. Under the act, which cleared the House of Commons earlier this week, Mr. Kenney will be able to create a list of so-called safe democratic countries that are unlikely to produce refugees, making it more difficult for someone from one of those countries to gain asylum. Gina Csanyi-Robah is the executive director of the Roma Community Centre in Toronto. Her work in advocating for Roma asylum seekers was recognized this month with the Queen Elizabeth II Diamond Jubilee Medal. And she joins us from Toronto. Good morning.
Good morning, Anna Maria.
What do you make of this Bill C-31, which just passed in the House of Commons, the Protecting Canada's Immigration System Act?
I think that it's a sad, sad day for the Roma people in Canada. It's also a sad day for Canadians in general. The language of this bill has really become a smokescreen for the removal of powers from what should be people and consolidating powers in the hands of a government official. There are so many issues in this bill that are going to hurt people, not just Roma refugees, but refugees across Canada. And I don't think that the average Canadian citizen is aware of how dangerous this new government legislation is. And it's hiding behind what is called the Protecting Canada's Immigration System Act. But what it's doing is actually endangering the lives of refugees that are coming here.
Well, I want to talk specifically about the Roma, but you say it could hurt people beyond the Roma population. Give me some of the shorthand. Where do you see that happening?
Well, the first thing is July 1st, interim federal health care will no longer be available for all refugees on the designated safe countries list. So anybody coming from what the government considers to be a democratic country will no longer have access to basic health care. This is including pregnant women. This is including children with perhaps asthma or other illnesses. It's including the elderly. It's including, people with diagnosed illnesses as diabetes or heart disease. I can't imagine that the average Canadian would agree to something like this if they truly realized what we're doing and how we're really jeopardizing the lives of people that have already been victimized before they ever reach the shores of Canada.
Well, you heard Mr. Kenney there speaking earlier this year about the Roma people specifically and immigration. What do you say to claims that the Roma have been abusing Canada's refugee system?
Well, I think that there's a myriad of fallacies that have existed. To begin, Jason Kenney continues to reiterate that he believes that Roma refugees are bogus, and he relies on statistics from the Immigration Refugee Board that he continues to manipulate and exploit. There is a much higher acceptance rate of Roma refugees than people realize. But what he has done is manipulate those statistics. And this is in a recent conversation that I've had with an Osgoode Hall professor who keeps track of these rates at the Immigration Refugee Board. So he takes the positive rates and divides that by abandoned and withdrawn claims. So there has been, at one point, an 85% acceptance rate of those refugees that made it to their hearings. Those that have not made it to their hearings, there has been a significant number of withdrawn refugee applications. But that should not make somebody, for whatever reasons it is that they may withdraw their refugee applications, and there are a number of reasons that have contributed to that. There are significant barriers for the Roma community in navigating the very complex immigration refugee system that exists in Canada. But whatever the fact, many have not made it to their hearings. And this has, and in fact, created this false belief that they're not legitimate refugees.
So who are the Roma? How do you describe your people to someone who has no idea?
The Roma people are probably the least understood people across the world in some ways. People have heard of gypsies. They've never heard of the Roma. They don't know us by our own name. And there's so many stereotypes, negative stereotypes, that have existed about us for so long that it's very easy to exploit these negative stereotypes, as the government has done, to be able to pass this new law. The Roma people originated in northwestern India over 1,000 years. We're the largest diaspora, arguably, in the world. We've been in Europe for 600, 700 years. We're not a nomadic people inherently. We've been forced to move on from place to place because we've not been accepted in a number of European countries. We're the largest minority in Europe. There's approximately 15 million of us. The vast concentration is in Central and Eastern Europe, where we face apartheid-like conditions often, and hate that is the type of hate that led to a large number of our community being killed during the Holocaust. People don't realize that almost 2 million Roma were also victims of the Holocaust. People also don't realize that there are conditions existing in many Central and Eastern European countries that are similar to what existed prior to the beginning of World War II. People don't realize that there's openly operating paramilitary camps and groups that are working in solidarity with ultra-nationalistic extreme right political parties in Central and Eastern Europe that continue to target the Roma community with hatred, racially motivated violence, and many murders that have taken place since 2008.
Okay, Gina Csanyi-Robah, we have to leave it there, but thank you for giving us some perspective on the Roma community.
I appreciate this opportunity. Thank you very much.
Thank you. That is Gina Csanyi-Robah. She is the executive director of the Roma Community Centre in Toronto. Her work in advocating for Roma asylum seekers was recognized this month with the Queen Elizabeth II Diamond Jubilee Medal.